Namaste friends, I am Satish Menon, a practicing astrologer, a spiritual speaker and a life guide. Welcome to my channel where I bring together the subject of astrology, spirituality and faith together into my videos. Today we are going to visit and know about one of the most popular temples in the southern part of India. We are going to take a divine knowledge tour of the Kollur Mugambiga Devi Temple. Kollur is about 130 kilometers from Mangalore and 80 kilometers from Udupi. The goddess here, Mugambiga Devi, is primarily the goddess of Vidya, that is knowledge and learning. And it is a very significant place of worship for people of southern states like Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. It is counted as the seven abodes of salvation created by Lord Parashurama. The goddess here is worshipped as goddess of speech, that is Vaka Devi. She is also worshipped as the goddess of arts and music, that is goddess Saraswati. So you will find a lot of professionals connected with areas like singing, acting, dubbing, voiceover artists, etc. coming here and taking the blessings. Another very important feature that this temple has and it's very popular for is the Vidyarambham ceremony that is done here. Vidyarambham basically means the beginning of education and learning. And the ceremony done here in the presence of Mugambiga Devi is considered as extremely sacred and auspicious. You will find a lot of parents bringing their small children here and conducting this ceremony. From the astrological point of view, if you are a voice professional, a singer, a teacher or a student, then visiting Kollur Mugambiga Devi temple and taking her blessings would be extremely beneficial for you. Also, if you or someone you know has issues related to speech, issues related to lack of focus in education, then a visit here is definitely advised. Remember, in astrology, our speech is governed by the second house of our horoscope. And in the standard Kal Purush horoscope, the second house is governed by the planet Venus. Venus represents Devi or female goddess. Hence, the connection with speech, music, arts, education, etc. The Devi here is on the top of a Swayambhu Linga. And there is a fine golden line that separates the Linga and the Devi's seating position. On the right side of the Linga, there is the abode of Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. And on the left side, there is the abode of Saraswati, Lakshmi and Durga. Hence, the goddess is considered to embody all the gods and goddesses. So, praying at Mugambiga Devi temple is considered as equivalent to praying to all gods and goddesses. The temple is believed to be over 1200 years old. Many noblemen, saints and kings have contributed to establishing and maintaining this temple. Inside the sanctum, you can find heavy influence of Kerala temple architecture. The temple opens for darshan at 5 a.m. and stays open till 9 p.m. except a small recess of half an hour in the afternoon.
Namaste Jagadatri Sadbrahma Rupe Namaste Karotendra Datra Divandye Namaste Prabhaneshta Daneika Dakshe Namaste Mahalakshmi Kolapureshi Vidhikriti Vasa सृजयति पादी यद्य प्रसिद्धम् कृपालोकनादेव शक्तिरूपे नमस्ते महालक्ष्मी कोलापुरेशी द्वयमायया व्याप्तमेतत्समस्त्वम् धृतं लीलया देवी गुप्तौ हि विश्वम् स्थितं बुद्धिरूपेण सर्वत्र जन्तौ नमस्ते महालक्ष्मी कोलापुरेशी
Just now are few lines from the Mugambika Ashtakam. The word Kolapureshi occurs many times in the Mugambika Ashtakam. The complete Ashtakam and the link to it is right there in the description box below. Kolapureshi, the word, because the place Kollur was earlier known as Kolapureshi. There is a story attached with the name Kolapureshi too. There are quite a few legends actually associated with Mugambika Devi and found in our Puranas. The first one that I am narrating here is from the Skanda Purana. There was a great saint in this land by the name of Kola Maharshi. He was an ardent devotee of the Holy Trinity and he would carry out many long penances in their name. In one such long penance, he impressed the Trimurtis, Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. They came down on the earth and impressed with Kola Maharshi, they said, "You have impressed us. Ask what you wish and we shall grant you." Kola Maharshi simply said, "Lords, I would just like you to stay at this very place and bless us all." Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh took abode here in the form of the Jyotirlinga. This place from then on was known as Kolapuri or Kolapureshi, dedicated to Kola Maharshi. After the time of Kola Maharshi, after many years passed, there came an asura known as Kamasura, who had received the boon of invincibility by Lord Brahma himself. The boon was that he could not be killed by God or man. When he realized, "Oh, I can be killed by a woman or goddess," he started penancing again and this time tried to please Lord Shiva. Just when Shiva was about to give him the complete boon, Devi, as the goddess of Vakdevi or speech, deserted him. At that moment, Kamasura couldn't speak, he couldn't ask for his boon. From then on, he was known as the Mook Asura. He realized that he had been tricked and so he got very angry and started breaking havoc on sadhus and noblemen. Devi Shakti had to come down on earth to fight the Mook Asura and finally end him. During his last breath, he pleaded to the goddess that he should be remembered by his name at least when people come to worship this place and visit Devi. The Divine Mother, in all her grace, agreed and gave him salvation. This temple, therefore, gets the name Mookambika, based on the name of Mook Asura, whom the Devi had vanquished here itself. Friends, each of these legends have a huge symbolic meaning behind them if we are open to understanding it. When you surrender to devotion like Kolar Maharshi did, then all the gods dwell inside you. And the Mukasura, he represents our inner and sometimes the quite negative thoughts and desires that may not have a voice but still hinder us from rising up spiritually. Which is, by invoking Devi and worshipping her, we can terminate and stay blessed. And probably that is the reason why the Navratri and then finally leading to it, the Dashera, is celebrated at Mugambika Devi in a very grand manner. Vijayadashmi Day or Dashera is considered a good day for Vidyarambham, to overcome ignorance by knowledge and learning and have victory or vijay over your inner demons of ignorance through learning and realization. Happy Dashera to all. Please spread the legend of this temple to your near and dear ones. And make sure you visit this temple when you get a chance. May Goddess Mugambiga Devi bless us all. We'll see you soon with another interesting video. Thank you for watching.